Welcome to today's Grow It Green. We're at the New Hampshire Food Bank, and I'm joined by Emma Erler of the UNH Cooperative Extension. And Emma, it's the middle of the winter. Many people think, well, that means just dried herbs. You're here to tell us that ain't so, huh?
Exactly. It's actually pretty easy to grow some common culinary herbs in the kitchen or in the house.
All right. So one of the ways you can do it is start by seed, and a lot of gardeners are familiar with these. Any sort of special seed mix that you need?
Yes, you should look for a seed starting mix. Usually that's really fine, it's peat based, it'll hold moisture, and it'll also be great for the seeds.
Okay, and we here have some herbs in front, and just how long does it take for them to germinate?
It depends on the plant. Most will come up in about 2 weeks. So some of these, say you're gonna grow parsley, you wanna start that indoors. The nice thing about this is that you might be able to harvest a little bit indoors and then you can transplant it into your garden this summer.
All right, sounds good. Now, for those of us who can't wait, and that's a lot of people in this generation, maybe mine too, but anyway, you can find some of these herbs in your local garden center or maybe supermarket. What do you need to look for as far as these go?
Yes, so you'll probably find a lot of these just in your supermarket, and they're pretty inexpensive. The thing you need to know is that a lot of these plants are packed in really, really tight. So if you want to keep this plant going for a number of weeks, maybe a number of months, what you need to do is actually thin this out. So, you know, take a few stems out and use those in the kitchen.
Okay.
Or divide this up and put them in separate pots.
That way, if you kill one, you'll still have another one there to go.
Right.
And speaking of that, when I'm going to harvest these herbs, how much can I take?
So I would recommend taking about a third of the plant at a time, no more than that, because you want to make sure it still has enough leaves to grow.
All right, now finally, we have a spray bottle here, but I've been told that I shouldn't spray leaves or whatever, and why do we have the spray bottle here for these guys?
Good, you're already giving them a miss. So the reason that's there is because herbs need a relatively high humidity for them to thrive. So one option is to mist them down once a day to make sure they have humidity around them. Another option is to take a nice plastic tray like this filled with stones, put a little water in the bottom, and put your herb on top. You don't want it sitting in the water, but you want to get some of that humidity from the water below.
All right, these are all culinary herbs, and you have something about a culinary challenge you want to tell us about.
Yes, yes. The New Hampshire Food Bank has their Steel Chef Challenge coming up in Manchester at the Doubletree on March 11th. So if you're interested in culinary herbs, that's a good place to experience them.
And support a great cause as well. That's it for today's Grow It Green.